who was coming. So every morning, suddenly he felt quite interested. He received that guest without even moving. Okay. They were not interested to receive that guest. Sat in with them, don't let them in. You imagine Christopher Columbus crossing that up. Isabella, Ferdinand sat here. And Isabella said to Ferdinand, don't let him in because we don't have money here to give it to go to this. What happened here, right? So the room for the throne is all of the decoration is Mordecai, 14th century. And then that dome, it was restored like in the 15th century, but also in the 14th. The name of this kind of room, we know it still as Cuba, with Q and double B. Because if you know, this is like a Q, and at the ceiling, they always have to have a dome. And that dome is cypress wood, painted, polychromate, and then they add glasses or mirror to give a reflection. Because that dome has quite a metaphorical meaning. On the one hand, trying to represent like the universe, that's why it's orange with the stars, or the celestial dome, and then the earth, where we are. But on the other hand, the meaning is that over the king, there is nobody else but God. And the rest of the plebeians, what we are talking about. That over the king is not that novelty that he was always fighting against. Just God. So being the king, he could do what they wanted. Right? And then, during the 16th century, when they add these four balconies that we go on each side, you see that it's wrought iron. That material is typically used during the Renaissance. To connect.